Hey, Laura, how are you doing today?
Hello, Gaurav. I'm really happy to be here. I'm fine, thank you.
Fantastic.
All right. How about yourself?
Fantastic. I'm very glad to be speaking to you tonight and also would like to welcome you as a speaker for our Regional Scrum Gathering Hyderabad, the 29th and 30th March 2019. For our viewers, I would like to mention that, you know, Laura, she's our speaker for the conference, and she is also an agile practitioner who loves to help people and companies grow and succeed, discover their potential, and take innovative steps forward, which is a great personal statement to have. So Laura, let me start with asking you to please introduce in your own words about yourself, and also talk to our viewers that what keeps you busy nowadays.
Hello, everyone, and thank you, Gaurav, for having me. My name is Laura Quattri, Laura, if you want. I'm originally from Italy. I've lived here and there around Europe for many years, and now I'm based in Milan. My great passion is communication. I like to help people communicate, find new ways and better ways to communicate and overcome their fears. And that is linked to what is keeping me busy today. I've been working in marketing and sales for many years, and now I'm working with everything that revolves around languages. I'm a professional language trainer and coach, and I'm a translator. And I'm also passionate about agility, and I'm a personal agility practitioner. So I combined my two passions, and I started translated manuals about personal agility, and also translated a very famous video about the role of the agile product owner for Italian audiences. And I've started giving talks about personal agility and my experiences with it. Apart from that, my other great passion that is also linked to communication is traveling. I love to travel, discover new cultures, meet new people, exchange, and have experiences in different ways of living. I try to live as a local as much as I can when I travel. And that has taken me to wonderful places to meet wonderful people. And it is very enriching. And I think I'm really lucky. This is will be my first time in India. And I'm really looking forward to discovering the richness of your wonderful country.
Wow, fantastic. And we are very happy to host you. And I really like what you just said, that you know, you like to live at a place as a local. And that's a great sentence you said, because you know that's when you can really consume and observe the place and really live it. Wow, that's fantastic. Fantastic. So any big plans for while you are in India? Any big plans out there?
Big plans
Big plans for being in India and traveling, any specific place? Are you planning to do something like that?
Well, unfortunately I will be there just for a few days, just for the gathering and a few days before. But even if the time is really tight, I hope I will be able to visit some places and get at least a little bit of flavor of India. But I hope I will be back soon.
Awesome.
Again to explore more.
And we wish you a very, very happy and safe journey, and have some fun while you are in India. So let me get to another question, Laura. And you know, you talked about that you have been a translator, and then you got into agility, and personal agility is something which you are a practitioner yourself. So how did this all started? These are two different fields completely altogether. So how did your agile journey started?
Well, my journey into agility started around 4 years ago, mm-hmm. when a colleague who is an agile trainer spoke me about agility, explained me how it works, the impact it has on the way people and organizations work. And that fascinated me, because I've always been working for very traditional companies, and the concepts that agility conveys are very refreshing for me. So I started by reading the Agile Manifesto, and from them I kept reading, researching, I talked to people, started getting in touch with the Agile community, and the more I learned, the more I discovered how powerful the agile concepts and the agile practices are. And so I was so enthusiastic that I took a course, I got a CSM certification, and I'm still learning and discovering. And then a couple of years ago, I was introduced to personal agility. There is a way to apply the agile mindset at an individual level. So we as individuals can focus on what's really important for us, what really has value for us. And so my journey is continuing, and I'm very excited to see where it will take me.
Wow, fantastic. Very good. I could see it in you, you know, how excited you are about this journey. You know, you're very good. That's always fantastic. You know, people with high energy, you know, really creates an impact in the community. Thank you very much. So, so what do you see from here? You know, I see that, you know, you just mentioned, you know, for the last 4 years, your journey started. So from here, what's your mission or vision from here around agility? Or for yourself, and what kind of an impact do you think you are looking forward in the community?
Well, as I said, I was involved with personal agility a couple of years ago, maybe a little bit more, a year and a half, and it really resonated with me. So I experimenting with it. I'm trying to really use it in my own life and sharing with people around me. Personal agility is inspired by the core principles of Scrum, and it applies them to the smallest possible unit, the individual. And the most fascinating thing is exactly that, I think, that the agile mindset can be taken beyond the world of IT, the world of company organization, and can be applied to our own lives, both at work, but also at home. And that's what really fascinated me about this concept. Personal agility helps us become aware of what we're doing, where we're going in life, and if to discover if that aligns what we what's really important with what. Sorry, personal agility helps people become aware of what they are doing, and if that aligns where they really want to go in life, the project they want to achieve. And because we only have limited time during our day, during our week, we need to make the most of that time and need to focus on what really gives us value. And that's exactly what personal agility is, and what I would like to transmit to people with my talk. It's all about alignment. Personal agility helps us discover if what we are doing is aligned with what we really want. And if we doesn't align, well, it helps identify where the problem is. And once we know where the problem is, it's easier to get on the right track and to start doing what really is important for us and what's making us life better. Maybe anything. Change careers, take better care of our health, lose weight, spend more time with someone we really care about in our life. And another thing that I found refreshing and that I would like to transmit about personal agility is that it doesn't make you feel guilty if you go off track. It's also based on a positive attitude. It's based on celebrating what you achieved rather than taking you down for what you wasn't able to achieve. And what personal agility does is to teach you to look at things differently and do things in a better way. Say no to toxic situation, say no to toxic relationship, and give us the tools to get unstuck if it's needed. It's as I said, a coaching stance. Personal agility help us to coach ourselves. And when we do that, it also becomes an attitude that influences the way we deal with people around us. And it also gives motivation to beat the big sins, procrastination, the multitasking issue that is a big problem for many of us. Yeah. And it's also flexible. We can adjust it to our life, to what we really need to do. And it's a very empowering concept, because what I would like to transmit with my work and with my talks when I speak around the world about it is that it gives us the possibility to take our life back into our hands, makes us feel good about ourselves and create a better environment around us and have an impact also on people around us.
Fantastic. Wow. I mean, you know, that's very beautifully defined. I picked up a few things from what you just said. You know, people can even overcome their procrastination issues. Wow. That's, I personally believe a lot of times, you know, we get into a trap of, you know, I'll do it tomorrow, I'll do it later and things like that. And personal agility can help. A lot can be accomplished if we just overcome our procrastination, I'm sure, as an individual. Wow. That's fantastic to know.
Well, before knowing, discovering personal agility, procrastination was one of my big issues. And thanks to personal agility, I started to understand why I was procrastinating. And once you understand the reasons, it's easy to find ways to change things. And that's because it's first-hand experience. I really happy to share it with other people, and I hope it will be helpful to other people.
Very good. And you know, we talked about a lot about personal agility, and I know that your topic is all around personal agility, and I the topic is a very, very interesting heading. You know, a late night bus trip, personal agility and me, how powerful questions can change life. I'm sure that you're going to talk about some tips, tools, techniques which, you know, people can use to enhance their personal agility around that. Is that a correct understanding around the topic?
In my talk, I will first of all tell how I discovered personal agility, how I got there, and the impact it had on my personal life. I will explain what powerful questions are, because they're such a powerful topic, and how we can use powerful questions to coach ourselves, to pinpoint the problems and solve them. And I'm also tell about how what I discovered took me to help someone I met, a total stranger I met, and who was in a very difficult situation. And by using the coaching stance that personal agility taught me, I was able to help him see clearly in his life and what he really wanted to do, what he wanted to change, and the changes that were that I saw in this person were really amazing. And I thought that it will be worth sharing that with you and with other people.
Wow.
Because it's very inspiring.
Absolutely.
I think it's a virtuous circle, you know. When you discover something important and beautiful and start doing it, you want to share it. And that irradiates around us, and we're able to inspire people. That's what I think it's the main message of personal agility, to inspire people to do better things, to do what really is important in our life.
Wow, that's fantastic. And that's really amazing to know that, you know how you can coach yourself, and you know, if there is a way that you can inspire people, because then they themselves will be like a powerhouse, and then, you know, they can do their own things, right? Very good, fantastic to know that. That's very interesting, and it's making me more curious to, you know more, and I'll not steal the thunder, because, you know, you're going to do the talk and you like to listen in detail while you are here in the conference. So, you know, from here, any message for the delegates attending this regional scrum gathering? I know in the past you would have attended a lot of conferences and things like that. So help our delegates, what they can expect, and what is your message to the delegates when they come to a gathering like this?
First of all, I would say to anyone do come to the gathering. There will be great talks from great speakers, fantastic keynote speakers too, and it will be a wonderful opportunity for learning, for sharing and exchanging experiences. It will be a great networking opportunity too. And I hope you will want to listen to my talk, listen to my experiences with personal agility and how life-changing it can be if you really want to change. So I look forward to seeing you in India.
Definitely, you know, it was really, really good. And I always believe that, you know, experience is the best teacher. I also believe experience is the best teacher, provided it is somebody else's experience, because you don't have to live that life to, you know, learn from others' experience. You can just learn from others. It was fantastic.